Good evening, and welcome to LNC, the local news channel. I'm your host, Jason Edwards, and today, being May 14th, we're going to talk about a few issues that are going on here in beautiful downtown Wichita, where LNC is located. We went out in the streets, got a few calls, and have came up with this week's issue. A lot of the issues that are needing to be addressed are talked about here in town. For one, anger. Something that I've been working on myself. Anger, the demon of destruction. How anger destroys families. How drug and alcohol use is used to mask our anger issues. And how anger robs the blessings that we may have from the Lord. Say, Jason, what are you saying? Well, let's look at today's paper, well, the paper from May 5th, here in the Wichita Eagle. Keeping the peace. As you can see, the man here and the woman here, not talking, not willing to talk, holding in issues that may have been happening probably from their early childhood. It could have been things that have happened during school. It could have been a fatherless home. It could have been a girlfriend that broke their heart a long time ago that they just haven't got over. Same with the woman. She may have gotten scorned. She may have gotten hurt by some man and is willing to take it out on her husband, and now the same two people who were in love with each other hate each other. The suburban white couple down here. The mother pointing at the child, the father talking. Mothers, stop throwing your kids in the middle and saying that you're not throwing the kids in the middle. The child is looking like, I wish they both would stop. Because what happens is that both parents wind up acting like two big kids. I've lived through it myself, and I pray and hope that my situation changes as well. But sometimes, when people have anger, things that stem out, when you hold on to that anger, you're basically bringing that anger into a relationship. And when you have those problems and bringing them into a relationship, guess what? You're not only destroying the relationship you had, you're letting that relationship destroy you, and you're destroying the relationship that you have. So now you have. So now you went from a problem to an even bigger problem, and thinking that leaving that relationship, going and taking that mess to somebody else is going to fix it. I got news for you. You're actually fooling yourself, being delusional. It's only going to make it worse. Seek professional counseling. Comcare, SAT, someone in town to where you can go talk about those issues so that you don't have to bring those issues into a relationship and keep your family together. Keep it whole. And this will probably bring you the peace and satisfaction that you've been looking for. Another big issue here is Kansas. Four women against men. In our court systems today, the 18th Judicial Court, I myself have experienced it. Our court systems today have given women the false belief that the court systems are going to fight in their favor, and so are the police. Got news for you. Everybody's going to jail nowadays, women and men alike. Police are called out once, maybe one person will go. Police caught out twice, both people are going. Some people are getting kicked out of their homes. This is leading to broken homes, homeless families, domestic violence, and ultimately for the father, it becomes unfair treatment. I myself brought all the evidence that I could. Woman filed a PFA on me. I taped it. She actually invited me over to the house after inviting a PFA on me. Guess what? When I played the tape back in court, you think that the judge did anything? No. Actually, he extended the case out, even though I had evidence. Her attorney actually didn't even know about the evidence. And instead of dropping the case like they should have, they continued the PFA. Even though it didn't go on my record, still gave them a chance to get me for child support and to take my children away and see them for once a month, and which the woman still now, because of anger, is not letting me see the children for things that happened to her as a child. This was 2006, and 5 years later, I'm still going through the same thing. But to my children, I do love you. I wish that I could see you. However, as long as that person holds on to the anger, just like some other women and some of you men, let it go. If that person doesn't want to be with you anymore, why make the children suffer? Court systems. Why is it that you don't believe the men? Why? Because they benefit. SRS benefits. Youth field benefits. All those involved because they get government money. Man goes to jail. Jail system gets money. The next thing you know, everybody is getting money at the expense of this family. And then when they separate child support and visitation, how are you doing the best for the children when you're taking the money from the father but not letting that man see his children? Who's really benefiting outside of SRS, outside of the court systems? Because the mother eventually goes downhill trying to find a man to raise her children. That man has to deal with the scorned woman. And then on top of it, trying to make amends takes 10, 20 years, and the children have grown, and they've grown bitter. And now you have a vicious cycle that continues. Parents, get it together. Court system, stop showing favoritism and being bogus. This is supposed to be a fair court, not her court. And last but not least, felons. The unfair treatment or prejudice of a people or a person trying to get ahead in life after making a mistake, probably paying their time, but now that they've paid their time and debt to society, cannot come back out to society and get a job. Trying to make a way, trying to not relive the same old mistakes, but ultimately leads back to a life of crime and stuck in an unforgiving system that doesn't allow someone to receive the same type of benefits as someone else just because they may not have gotten caught for doing the same type of crime. This issue is definitely touchy as well. This here is a monitor that goes on your ankle bracelet for felons. It's the most embarrassing and humiliating thing that a person can suffer. My suggestion is, first, stay out of trouble. Avoid drugs, alcohol, work on your anger issues, stay away from bitter and hateful women and men who are just using and abusing. Get your life together. These are things that I'm trying to work on. I'm not perfect and I'm not trying to be perfect. I'm just a news reporter. However, people downtown Wichita, take heed. Life is short. Don't spend all your time just trying to get by. Make something of yourself. And make something for your children. I'm Jason Edwards. And this edition of LNC, the local news channel. Have a blessed day.